Hello everybody and welcome once again to Running Red, the hardcore questing mod from Gideon Seymour. In this episode, let's start from the beginning. You may be able to not hear the rain. In fact, that is the case. Here I actually built a rain muffler and it is lovely. I can't hear the rain at all. And the recipe, by the way, for the rain muffler is simply sound mufflers in a sort of chest formation. Let's have a look. With a bucket of water. And the sound muffler was simply wool around an oak block, which is wood around a redstone. So, isn't that lovely? No more rain. That's fantastic. Now, at the end of the last quest, we got this ruin key here. And let's go and see what happens with this now. So look at the chest quest book and Our Lady and Sorrows. Oh, yes, well worth collecting anyway. I've been busy. That wasn't what I was coming here for. So Head First for Halos is now completed. And there are no repeatable quests in this one as far as I remember. Everything's done. So now we have Demolition Lovers. And Demolition Lovers has got this one quest where we had to do this, which was in the quest delivery system, submit one ruin door key. So we select the task. Let's go over to the quest delivery system here, right click it, and put into the hopper the ruin door key. And what happens then? We hope it's now finished. So that then opens up more quests. In fact, this one I've already completed. What that was to do was to produce the 36 blood ruins and 4 large bloodstone bricks. Well, we did that before in order to make the tier 4 altar, so I'm a little bit ahead since I've already built the tier 5 altar. So we'll claim the reward anyway. And I think I already have another red heart canister here, which I do. And we shall simply take those two, combine those two, and eat it to give me 24 lives. And what did we have? A basic reward bag. Let's have a look in there. So we've got one notch apple and 4 golden apples. Actually, if you look at the recipe for a notch apple, it's about 9 times more than a golden apple, so this is actually a really good reward. Instead of using ingots of gold around an apple, use blocks of gold around an apple to make a notch apple. So what did I want to do? I wanted to get rid of this stuff here and put away the rest of it. Let's do that first. As my diamond supply is rather short at the moment. Let me just do this one. 25,000, that's fine. I'll just got some artificial hives in here which I want to make to scented artificial hives. If you can hear me with that din, so we don't want that. So I can put the other bits away. In fact, I don't know where I'm keeping golden apples at the moment. I think they're still at the back here, so let's just do that. Oh, wrong chest. It must be this gold chest here. Yes, let's put those into there as well. It's getting well full of both notch apples and golden apples. Look at that. In fact, all the chests are getting full. But the bees have been busy too. And by the way, if you want to make mushrooms populate, the best way to do this, let me get this magnetism turned on first of all, is just to plant one or so around a big tree. And then you can collect the others. The flowers, of course, are coming from the bees. They're pollinating flowers. Take those. Now, this is actually interesting. In fact, let me move this chest. No, I didn't collect it. Let's go and do that first of all. because I was a little bit puzzled as how to do something before, and that was how to make basically an AND gate with a NOT on the other side. There may be a simpler way to do what I'm trying to do. Let's have a look what I've got here. So here I have an Autronic gold AND gate. And this basically allows me to power up things. Well, this is where I'm trying to do it is to get a rocky hive. Again, it's failed, so I'll try and do this. Oh, I forgot to get what I wanted to get anyway. Let's go and get what I wanted to get, which was the gravity gun, which is in here. I want to move the chest, basically. I made a second gold chest because the first one had already got full. And I wasn't going to mess around making... I put it over here because that then becomes underneath the trees, as it were. Let's put this safely out of the way and have a look. In here I've got lots of bees. Just a second. I just paused the video because I needed to have a cough. Right. And what I wanted to do basically was with these chocolate frames to be able to turn off a gate. So let's come round here. And also get from in here a wooden transport pipe. And the idea is, I think I need something else as well. Anyway, let's put the wooden transport pipe down here and put the gold and Autronic gate in here. Very flashy thing, isn't it? So what I want, you can then click the interface. And if I right click in here, it basically says no frames. So this will be no frames and no princess missing. So that will then basically, what I want to do is not this. So I want frames and I want a princess missing to give me a red flag. So the way you do that is you can then take some red wire pipe. You can either put red wire or blue wire, it doesn't make any difference on a gold one. I can put, say, the blue down here or the red down here, and it goes around the side of it like this. And this time when I click it, I can say here I want a blue pipe signal, and then I can say here when I've got no blue pipe signal, I think there's actually a lot more options in here like this, then we can do a red, an energy pulsar. Oops, just that, as you see. So what that's saying is we must have some frames in here, because that's true. We've got no printers in here, so we want the energy to pulsate round. And sure enough, that's the case. If I take one of these out, now I have to take all three out, so let me just put the other ones, the new ones, away again. And you also notice I've got some new hat and some new comb in here. I also got this dripping comb. And the usage of dripping comb, oh, is that right? Is I might get a honey drew drop and a honey drop as well. So in fact I will get a 40% chance of normal honey. And in fact this is basically used in the same way as all the other ones. You can use this for making glycerine melons, which is one of the brewing recipes, of course. And it's also used in conjunction with royal jelly to make ambrosia. Not sure what we do with that, but there we are. So now this is turned on. So what we need to do, of course, is go and get some more piping for this. And I don't have more propolis. So I need one of those, and I need... What else do I need? It was a stone transport pipe, I think. So I'll put the stone pen transport pipe on top of it, like that. And then you see it changed a little bit. And we need to go make another one of these. So let's go and do that. walking carefully around all the stuff that we have these days. It's getting quite full. So now I need to squeeze some honey. It's unlikely from three honey I'm actually going to get it. So I probably ought to go get some more. But while we're here, let's put away this. So let's go and get some more honeycomb. We have a lot of honey. Oops, caught myself again on that thing. We have a lot of honeycomb, as you can see. So 48, probably enough now to get some propolis. And you'll see over there, it's a little slime farm sort of spawning away. In fact, there's something else I want to show you about that as well. Where are we now? Squeezer, don't we? Now, squeezer is not squeezing this because... Is this tank full? Seed oil in here. What's in the pipe? Nothing. Oh, because I'm being daft, I have to put this into the centrifuge. And I've got 58. Honey, so we can put the 58 honeys in here and hopefully we get a propolis from here. And if not, it goes into this tank here. You can see it sort of floating up. There, we got one already. Good. So now I've got two propolis. That was very good, actually. Let's go make a press pipe. Let's go and do that. Again, shift it. So this time we want to say the black is only B, of course, and the blue, I think it is everything else. That's correct. So this is basically the hive that we're using. Let's have a look at this one here. I've configured this slightly differently. I could change this to give a blue signal, and then on a you can actually go around like this and say, and a blue signal we have here, which is true, we can then do a redstone output here. So those two have to be true. So it should be on, and gate should be off, but it looks like it's on. Oh, because it's knotted. Anyway, this one here is telling me I've got no hives in it, because all this is a straightforward gate, no frames, redstone signal. So let's put some in here, and the same is true in here. Wrong mist. I want to not automate this at the moment. I want to, oh dear, I haven't turned this off yet, so let's just turn that off. That was a shift right click, by the way, because what I want to do is now to reuse this hive, because I managed to get a pristine noble princess and a drone. So then we can breed those two together, just like normal bees, as it were, and get a few more noble drones, because that's the next part. We've also got the diligent, but not very many of those at the moment. Like, what's wrong with this looking? Diligent bee. In fact, let's just... Yes, I do need these. Let's put those in here. Right. And princess. So we managed to get a diligent princess here. So that, of course, was made using a cultivated princess and a common drone. Now, we don't have any more cultivated princesses yet, so we need to make another one of those. So the idea is we've got in here common princesses, that's lots of those, and it needs hives, so frames. Let's get the frames out. Six we need. Put those into here. For those to work, then you see the lamp, as it were, goes off. And the same with here. Now here we have 14 cultivated drones, and these will be pure bred drones. We can check that out for a start. I didn't really intend this to be a yes, pure cultivated, sorry. So we can then take another princess. I think we can take a stranded forest princess here. Put it in with a cultivated drone, and hopefully we will end up with a what will we end up? I need to get purebreds coming in through here. So hopefully we'll end up with a cultivated princess, and then we can use that cultivated princess with the other one, and we should then get, oh, in fact I'm going to put these two in here because I want to do something with that, and the rest I'm going to put in here. Let's sort that with a common and get hopefully another diligent, but it's likely you can get a noble as well. So right now, that's that done for today. Oh yes, there was one more thing I wanted to show you. Wrong place again. Are these slime plant seeds? What I found with slime plant seed, you plant one. Let's just get out of here. Yes, that's right. So you just plant it, press Q on it, let it land. Hopefully it plants. And then you hit it with the seagull, or it doesn't matter what you use. Bone meal or the green grove sigil, you right click it twice and then hit it, and this time you get it reproduces. So if you do it three times, you'll get a slime. Didn't get any of that time, quit that out like this. Try again, 1, 2, hit it. You see we've got now, we've already got three from the one. In fact, I don't want to leave that down there because I don't want slime spawning in here particularly. And they have their own place. And you'll see these things are multiplying like crazy because I left the green grove on. And underneath here, I implemented the ritual of green grove because I wasn't getting enough seeds. If you look in here, I'm now getting enough seeds. Look at this lot. I can take 9 sets of seeds because that's the maximum. Actually, put those up there. That's the maximum we can put into the squeezer. We'll do that over here. And let those squeeze away. And then that'll put seed oil into here. And I've already got 64 impregnated sticks in here, but not enough wood for the next 64. Maybe it's 32. You need 64 blocks, only one for each. Right. Now let's go back to the quest book again. Of course, looking at my hunger bar, I am hungry again. And I must have been to the Nether, which I have been, because my health bar is incorrect. It should be showing 12, so I should have 2 yellow ones. Doesn't matter, we have the health, I'm sure. So let's go back here. So this one here is vampire money. What have we got to do here? Ruins of self-sacrifice. Ah, well, how many have we got to make? 4. Okay, let's think about that. We get 45 florbs and half a heart. Okay, and the other one, let's go back, there's this one here, Burning Light. And here we've got to make some particle generators, a self augmenter, and a melee aggregator. These are blood magic items. So let's get on with that. So the first thing we need to make was a rune of self sacrifice. And I know this is a tier 4 item because it needs the master blood orb. So it's 2 blank slates, blood ruins, well, we got plenty of those. So, and 2 glowstone dust. So in this chest we should have plenty of everything we need. So it was just blank slates, wasn't it? 2 blank slates, blood ruins, 4 of those, I think. Maybe we have to do a lot more, don't we? Is it 16 I need? Because I've got to make double. So I need 8 blank slates, then one master blood orb, which we've got plenty of because I was making this, and we need 8 of these glowstone dust. Let's go and do that again. Now, if I remember rightly, this thing doesn't work properly, but we can go. That's a right click halves what you've got in your hands. So, and then we've got our 4 blood runes. Let's take the master blood orb out. This one isn't associated to me, it doesn't seem to matter. And these particle generators. Let's go back. Oh, look at this. 100% claim reward. Let's go and put these floorbs in the place where I'm keeping floorbs at the moment. That's a lot of floorbs. I already completed the next quest by the looks of it. What was that one? That one? This one. We had to make a planter and a harvester. Oh, well, that's pretty good, isn't it? So I get another yellow's heart canister for that. Where does that go to? Let's put this into place. Which is great. I actually made one because I've got a lot of yellow hearts from... Well, 4 yellow hearts from the doing the wither skeleton, wasn't it? Not the wither skeleton, the wither. Now, let's go back to the quest book because I can't believe I've done too many of these. Nether stars. I have to kill certain monsters. And I've got to kill one. And that'll be the wither. I reckon. It looks like a wither skeleton, doesn't it? But I think it's a wither. Right. While that's happening, let's go and do the other task, which was the particle generators. This thing. Ah. This is a little bit more tricky by the looks of it. So I need to make a projectile core and some stone braces. What was the other things we need to make? Let's go to the quest book. Double check that one. Because this is this direction. That was a particle generator, a self augmenter, and a melee aggregator. Let's have a look. Maybe it's easier to do the at blood magic business. If I can spell, which I can't. As usual. So that was this one. That's again 2 braces, a self core, and an output spell cable. Some quite interesting bits and pieces in this, which we haven't made before. And this one's similar. So this one here is reinforced plates, and that makes one of those. And we need one of each of these, don't we? So we need 2, 4, 6. That's no big deal. We've got plenty of reinforced slates. Let's go and get those. Nine. I have 21, which I think is not enough reinforced slates. As you see, I've got plenty of reinforced slates. So it was like this, wasn't it? 3 times. We need 6 of those. And then iron. I guess I've got enough. I just dragged it along those spaces and it produced that. So we have 5. Oops, not enough. I didn't think so. But there's no shortage of iron. Right, there's just 6 stone braces. Next item. This one, an output spell. That's fairly straightforward too. Okay, and we need 3 of these, I think. So we need 9 stone and 6 iron and 3 catalysts. 3 simple catalysts, we've got plenty of. There was something I was a bit disappointed with. And it was this ballard. Let's go and have a look at that before I finish this off. In here, I have all the ingredients I need to make, take the simple catalyst out, to make the weak binding agent. So if we look at the recipe for this, the weak binding agent, mundane lengthening agent, is made from a weak binding agent. The weak binding agent is made with two simple catalysts and some clay. And the catalysts are made with, redstone, sugar, glowstone, and gunpowder. So I had four to do this. So I was expecting, if I took this item here, put this into here, after empty some space up. So if I put the weak binding agent in here, I was expecting to see on this stand the intermediate ingredients, because I don't see any point in doing this, because if you're just putting in clay into there, anybody can do that. I don't need any magic for doing this. So it seems to be a bit of a disappointment, this ritual. I was hoping it to be smarter than that. Anyway, back to what we're doing. So simple catalyst, I have three of those, and it was for the recipe. So look. Right, so stone I have got plenty of. We need three of these, don't we? So let's put this like that. And iron ingots. In fact, I don't need to do it like this. We'll have three of these. Take the rest away. So we have three of those, six of those. Some blank slates. Let's have a look at the next bit. So this one here is, it's another fairly straightforward recipe. Two reinforced slates. Okay, so we need three of these again, I reckon. So I just happen to have six, that's great. Gold, we've got plenty of gold, stone. And iron. I'll do the division way. I can't make more than threes because I've only got three, so there we go. Let's double click that and take them away. So I reckon that's probably as far as I'm going to get with this, because the rest of it's fairly straightforward, just this projectile core. Oh, okay. We can make some of this. This is Magicalis. Magicalis is made with two glowstone, one simple catalyst, and gunpowder and redstone. Gunpowder we have absolutely stacks of. What do we have in here? We've got some of this, some gunpowder, and it was twice as many as that. So we needed four of these, I think. So we'll stick those in there. Gunpowder and simple catalysts. Let me just check the recipe for Magicalis again. This one, I mean. Yes, four Magicalis, two arrows, one blue shard will give me an empty core. Oh, I need an empty core. So we need simple catalysts, glass, gold, and iron. Okay. Is that a crafting recipe? I missed it. I think it must be. Yes, it is. Shaped crafting. Okay. Let's take these out of here. Put the bits that we don't need immediately back into this chest, because my inventory is getting pretty full. Quick sort. Right. Okay. So we need an empty core. I reckon I'm going to need three empty cores. So the empty core was, go back to the recipe here. Okay, one, two, three of those. Gold, we've got still got plenty of. You can't count. Glass, four. Well, it's going to be a bit close. Right clicking again. Iron. So now I've got three empty cores. for glass. So I need one empty core in the middle. I should probably put all three in. So the magic colors, we go around the sides. So we need I think that's a magician's blood orb. So in magician's blood orb, two arrows, which we've got of course, and one blood shard, weak shard, blood shard. Do I have the, yes, I have the magician's blood orb in here. And weak shards, we have a significant number of. That will take one out of here. She's also getting reasonably full. Take three of those. I bet you the weak blood shards used in all of these are projectile. Cool, great. Next one is this one here. So this one's got to have Sanctus. Okay, Sanctus is made with glowstone, gold, a glass, and that. And we need four of those. So we need four glass, which we've got just enough of, but to make some more, or go and get it from the other chest. Four glass, gold nuggets. I don't know whether I have, but I'll take one gold. What else did we need? Glowstone, which we do have over there, and simple catalyst, which we've got here. Looks like I'm going to have to make loads more of those, but they get used in every single recipe. What was it? We need four, don't we? Gold nuggets. I'm not sure I've got enough of those. I've got plenty of gold nuggets. Let's put that up there. Gold nuggets out. I've had to split these in. And what was the last component? Was it redstone? Glass. Should be able to remember that. Smoking away, great. So that means we're working. Oh, that's one Sanctus. In fact, while we're here, let's have a look at the other one. This is the melee aggravator, so we need incendium in this one. So that's two glowstone powder, lava, and netherrack. Okay, let's go and get to the netherrack. I think there's be plenty of netherrack in it. Actually, maybe not enough. Maybe not enough. Let's take a stack of sand and turn that into glass, because we're going to need lots of glass. In fact, I have lots of thickened glass, I made tons of that, and I have got a little bit of glass in here, not that much. Okay, we'll take a stack of that, because we'll be finished the other stack off. Netherrack. That's going to be more interesting. We might have to make some netherrack. We've got plenty of string, of course. Let's go and do that up here, because it'll go very fast up here. And I have to be very careful, of course, cars. Take the food out of the way. Have I got enough space? Yes, I have. That out of, oops, wrong one. Take that out of there, put that back into here, and wait. I reckon it's not going to take very long to do these. They're only 50 LP and they go very fast. So we then end up with a stack of soil, first of all, dirt, and then it'll be netherrack before it goes to cobblestone. It's been a while since I've had to make cobblestone. In fact, I'm sure the altar's got plenty in it. Well, let's have a check while we're doing this. Where is my divot? Oh, it's already gone to dirt. I could have put dirt in, of course. I'm looking for, there we go, plant number four. Oh yes, plenty. Look, you see it's keeping up quite happily with the flow of the thing, even with me standing there. Now that might be because I put into here some of that cursed earth. Let's have a quick look. Oops, if I try to fly in the wrong place. So I put some cursed earth down here and here. But unfortunately, I do have to wait for this, because it will change to cobblestone even in a tier 1 altar, so I can't tweak it in any way. But you just don't know how long it's going to take. But as you can see, it's still in its 20,000. You can hear the mobs spawning. There we go. Drag it out of the way. Fantastic. Right, that was that one done. So we need some lava and buckets. I'm going to have to put some of this stuff into this chest, because I do not have enough storage capacity on me at the moment. We don't need a glass with me, I don't think. Let's put this chest up here. What else can we put in here? Let's put the weak blood shards in. Need the melons probably. The only thing I need that I don't need are these golden apples, but I won't do that now. I need buckets of lava, I need at least another space. Okay, let's get some space. Let's put this other half a heart in here. And that will be enough space for four of those, but let's put this. Now let's put the chest where I put my tools, which is in this one here. Useful items go in here. Blood magic items go in here. So we could put these four runes of self-sacrifice in there. Let's have a look. Yes, got enough space now. Sort that, and I need some buckets, and I need four buckets, don't I? I've got that, four of them. Don't need me Beelizer on me at the moment. Now, of course, I've got to go around the back here. Of course, I can take it out of here as well. So I need one of those. Let's get these items out of the way. We need netherite. Now, what was the recipe for this one? It was this one, wasn't it? Yes. Ah, yes. Netherite. We need four netherite. Have plenty of simple catalysts and blaze powder. Okay, I can put away the glowstone for those. Stick the whole lot in there. Doesn't make any difference. Simple catalysts I need four of, and blaze powder is the other one. Two sets of blaze powder, that's right. Now, blaze rods I have a stack of, but blaze powder I don't. So we need to get to need a wrong chest. It's nicely filled up. Also wrong chest. Here we have 48 blaze rods. I think that just two is going to be enough. We're going to get six out of that, that's 12. Yes, that will give me six. So here we need the pulverizer, which of course is full as usual. Take that out of there, and one of these out of here. That's not pulverizing. Shove those on the ground. Let's go and take the iron and put the iron in here. There's probably space in the hopper now. Oh, there isn't. Oh, no. Oh, I thought it was iron orbs. I can't. I was hoping to put that in. Never mind. I'll shove it in here for the time being, and we'll stuff the orbs in there as well. And of course I'll forget what that's in that chest, so we needed blaze powders. In fact, I can get those out of here. Blaze powders, eight. Eight, and a sulfur. Can I get rid of that one? No, I can't. I'll put that in the hopper up here. Right, eight is actually fine. I guess I got four, didn't I? Not six. This one you have to do manually. Any ones with buckets and on bottles you have to do manually. You can't do it automated. The only reason you'd probably use the ballad of alchemy. It does save you having to put them in by hand, but it doesn't take too long. There we go, get rid of those. So now, I think we have everything. I'll put the nether rack in here, because it's one of the base ingredients for this stuff, so it's useful to have it in here. The buckets, I'll put back into this chest over here. And everything is dandy. Now we can make the other three items, I think. So, we needed, for this one, we needed the self core, which is glowstone, which I probably haven't got two of those. I reckon that's going to stay the same. So the four sanctus and glowstone. Oh, I have got glowstone. Self core, and the other one was a sanctus. What was the other one in here? It was a melee core. Oh, we need fire charges. Coal, blaze powder, and gunpowder. Actually, that's not too difficult. I need to go and get another blaze rod. One chest. That's unlucky. That'll make four, that's fine. And of course, I've got to put that into the pulverizer, which of course is full as usual. Do it this way around. Out these three, and then we've got a chance of getting something in there. Let's put that back, all of the stuff that we don't really need at the moment, in here. Now we should have the blaze powder. Oh, we actually got another sulfur, so the blaze powder has given me sulfur. That's good to know. In here. So we needed coal and gunpowder. Right, coal I have stacks of. I think I've put it in here. So we needed to make two of these, didn't we? We need gunpowder. Gunpowder's in here. What was the recipe? I think it was just shaped, wasn't it? So probably the order is probably important. It gives me three fire charges. Oh, that's strange. We needed two. Oh, got six. Okay. Right, and there's our last core. Oh, I did have some. I didn't notice that. Never mind. Blind as usual. So now I've got these three cores. So let's see if we can make what we need to make. So. Put these three here, half those, right click it. Gold we need, one, two, three. And then we basically put one of these cores in each one, I think. Clicking with particle generator, relay aggregator, and a self augmenter. And that quest should now be complete. Let's have a look. Claim rewards, oh, fantastic. Gun. Let's do more flubs, half a heart, and got a bag. Well, quickly have a look at what's next on the agenda to do. So here we have way down, which is need to make a long fall boots. And I'll get another heart gold card, so that's interesting. No idea how to do that, we'll have a quick look. And over here we had to build killer wither. Well, we've done that before, so I'll do another one of those off camera and come back when that's done. Until next time, I hope you enjoyed this episode. Another long one, I'm sorry about that. Bye for now.